हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रेरणा एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑडियो स्टोरी टेलिंग प्रोजेक्ट इंडिया। टुडे आई एम हैप्पी टू टेल यू दैट आवर इंस्पायरिंग इनिशिएटिव ऑडियो स्टोरी टेलिंग प्रोजेक्ट हैज कंप्लीटेड 1 ईयर। On this great occasion, I have come with a wonderful story for you all.
Kali hansi to phool khila, phool se hanse nazare, lekar hansi nazaron ki, hans diye chand sitare, hans diye chand sitare. तुम सितारों की तरह, तुम नजारों की तरह, जिंदगी में सदा मुस्कुराते रहो।
दिस स्टोरी हैज रिटन बाई वेंकटेश गोविंद राजन सर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर टुडे स्टोरी। स्पीकिंग, लिसनिंग, writing, reading, helping, some ways by which you communicate with the external world. We all have tongues, but do we always speak softly, politely and clearly? We all have ears, but do we listen patiently to what others have to say us? How often do we use our fingers to write letters with pen or pencil to friends and family members who stay away from us? How often do we read attentively to what others write to us? How often do we offer to help someone in need, to do something we can which will be useful to someone else, even if that person is a stranger? Think carefully, then ask yourself this question: how important all these things? Do they help you to do well in life, to work better and feel successful? Do they make you feel confident of yourself? I am sure they do. And many of you may now want to try speaking more to express your views. You may try to listen more intently when someone is speaking to you. You may want to write letters. You may also want to spend more time reading to try to understand what the writer has tried to say. Remember that we had talked about how reading is a very good habit to have. Now, let us talk about a person about whom we already know and seek inspiration from that way she lived her life. Varshita Venkatesh, about whom I had spoken on the 25th of June last year, on her 49th birth anniversary. Varshita was an excellent communicator. She had to go to Norway to stay there with her husband Venkatesh, and she immediately realized that she would have to learn a new language, Norwegian. She was 36 years old, but that did not matter. She worked hard, harder than a school girl would work, and over time started speaking the language well. She was never afraid of making mistakes when she spoke. She tried, learned, improved, and soon was very fluent in speaking Norwegian. She also was able to write and read very well. Even the Norwegians were surprised at how fast she had learnt their language. At work in the university in Norway, she used to read her emails very carefully to understand how she could help students. No email went unanswered. She was very prompt. She made promises and kept them all. She always used to listen attentively when someone spoke to her, as she wanted to be able to help, encourage, comfort, praise, and appreciate whenever she could. Because she was a good communicator, people in Norway admire her, like and respected her, and trusted her. One can say that her most favorite mode of communication was helping others. She used her speaking, listening, reading and writing abilities to do so. Just like Varshita, we can all create a willingness in our hearts to success in life and help others succeed. Speak, listen, read and write with the purpose of making the world around us a better place to live in. I want to thank Venkatesh Govindarajan sir for writing wonderful stories for children. Also, I am very thankful to Aarti Naik Changemaker for providing continuous opportunities to present such amazing stories every day. Tomorrow I will come with another beautiful story for you all. Until then, take care and stay safe, my lovely friends. Bye.